Okay, we're back with another episode, and we're gonna continue where we left off, and we're gonna go to Stone Hill. Nothing nicer than portals in an overworld to just go straight to the level. It's pretty nice, I think, for you to do it this way. But anyway, so the goal of the game is to get all the gems and rescue all the dragons. Now, this level's a little tricky, and I won't go to the tricky part just yet. I'll just do the normal stuff. You can ram them. You can ram the rams, the huge rams, or you could torch them if you really want to. But for speed, I would just ram them since they don't slow you down or any of that. Let's go in this room. Do I hear blinking? Is it a life? Yeah, something. Oh, yeah. Don't let go of the button when you're ramming against them, or else you'll lose. So those little blink ones, they give you extra lives. Astor, what is he gonna tell us?
After you freed all the dragons, through this fancy vortex thingamajigger. It'll take you back to the artisan home. But first, let me tell you a story.
No, thank you.
See ya. See, he knows. I don't want to hear no long story of back when he used to be a whippersnapper, because that might have been thousands of years ago, and I'm not even kidding. Dragons live forever sometimes. But yeah, anyways, so let's go this way. And remember, kill the little fodder, in this case, they're sheep. And I love that sound. When you break the metal crates, it's pretty nice sound. Alright, Lindar. Who comes up with these names? It's like Star Wars names.
When you free a dragon or step on one of their platforms, you're saving your progress. That could be useful if you run into trouble. Not that you ever run into trouble, Spyro.
Dang right, I don't run into trouble. See, he knows. He knows better than to be, you know, misunderestimating me here. Oh, and then there's this little thing down here. So, there's that. Oh, we need a key. Oh, no explanation here. You know what I mean? But you use common sense. We need a key. So we're going to find that key. Gavin. That's a regular name.
Watch the dragonfly, Spyro. His color indicates his power. When he eats butterflies, stay strong, like me.
Sure.
He's like, you're full of yourself. But he doesn't want to say anything. But yeah, you relate with Spyro. He's like, sure, you're strong, whatever. He's like, does this face look like I care? No. Anyway, so that's 100 gems there. Alright, let's keep going. And that, stupid sound that used to haunt me in some levels back when I was little, because some parts were hard. Basically what it is, it's this cloaked monster thing. I don't know what the heck it is. But anyways, I should read the manual if I really want to know what it is. Anyways, so... Oh shoot, they're hitting me. So these ones you have to torch. Oh wait, no, you don't have to. I was about to show you getting hurt by them by not torching, whatever. Anyway, so you don't need to do that, apparently. Not opposite of what I thought, contrary to what my belief was. Anyways, we go up here on this whirlwind, we come up here,
and we find Glidus.
No, Gildas.
Spyro, my friend, how about a hint on gliding?
You bet.
For the longest glide, press the X button at the top of a jump. And try pressing the triangle button to drop down in mid-flight.
That's actually very useful when you don't want to overshoot something. So that hint was actually very helpful. And the fact that Spyro was enthusiastic about it kind of made you want to hear about it. I'm just saying. For future game developers, if you're listening to it. Oh shoot, I'm dead. Whatever, we got lots of lives anyways. Let's keep pushing. Not gonna make that mistake again. So this is kind of the first secret, is to come up this way. But it's not really much of a secret, because you kind of like you're kind of not like, you're told, you're not told, you see gems on that ridge that I jumped toward, and you see that, even if you weren't looking at it directly, you would see glistening, and you know those are gems after, you know, after you play the game for a while. Oh, those are gems. If you hear, if you see sparkling little white things in the background, those are gems. But anyway, so those things carry dragon eggs. Get the dragon eggs. You don't want bad guys to have your species, future children generation. What if they convert those eggs for their cause and let's not die again? That's what I get for gliding too haphazardly. Anyways, let's a nice way to make a barrier that doesn't look ugly is by making these kinds of things, but then they have a force field thing. It doesn't look ugly. It actually looks like it'd be part of, you know, the scene, but you know, you get the idea. Don't make an ugly barrier. I can chase him again if I really wanted to. Oh, I'll chase him again, because it's fun. Oh yeah, if you defeat an enemy again, it gives out that little crystal-looking thing, and that just means that... What's it called? If you get enough of those, you get another life. That's what it means. Anyway, so there are some gems in here. It's a little tricky. I'm hiding gems over here. What do you think I am? Sherlock Holmes? I'm not gonna figure this stuff out that easily. Especially when I was tiny, I could never find this. I can never find these gems. Oh, there are gonna be gems out here. Now that I'm older, I'm like, there might be gems here. You know, that's where I would hide it if I were a game developer. Now I can actually think more critically than when I was younger. That's the beauty of growing up with video games, is that when you're little, sometimes you just can't figure everything out, right? And when I was growing up, there was this fancy smancy internet that I had 100% access to, and everybody already uploaded everything about every game, right? So you had to figure a lot of stuff out on your own. And a lot of it had to do with your own personal exploration of the game. You know, you had to fight stuff. So for instance, you see that sparkling? You see it? You see it in the background. You see it. That's a hint. So if you guys are going to play the rest of this game, take note that if you see something like that where in the background there's shiny stuff, go towards the shiny stuff. Do that in other games too. Look at this. They hide this box crate thing right here. That's wrong. You could barely see it, but you know, it creates for more exploration, and the design of the world's pretty cool, I think. You know, it's pretty, it's very appealing. It has a theme and everything to it. So now let's go to that little secret thing that I want to show you that took me a while to figure out, actually. I'm not gonna lie, you know, to you guys, it took me a while to figure this out. So here's a hint to where you figure it out, is there's a whirlwind there. Now why would there be a whirlwind there? It means that there's something below that takes you to the top here. So if you fly down here, there's a beach. And at this beach, there are gems, and there's a tunnel, and there's the key. Remember, we needed the key to unlock that treasure chest. And I'm really hoping that after I unlock that treasure chest, there are only 10 gems in that treasure chest, or I'm gonna have to be upset and have to find all the other stuff. Anyways, so that was that. Okay, let's charge. Full speed ahead. All right. Drop down, and I'm gonna glide so that I don't hurt my butt. Let's unlock this nice and sturdy chest. Is that 10? 10? 10? 10? Yes! 200 out of 200 and 4 to 4. So, just check your inventory in the start menu to look up your progress. So that's 100%ed this level for you guys. Hope you guys enjoyed. And yeah, the world one's in the middle of the thing. Alright. So where is this? Sorry. I think this is where this is where you're supposed to go. Anyways, hope you guys enjoyed, and stay tuned for another episode where I go to another, through another portal to another world and find all the gems and goodies of that world. Stay tuned.